Hello, once again, I can announce another building project. While I was building the Doll 362, a friend of mine reached out and said, well, I'm pretty impressed with what you're doing. And I've always had this dream of having a horizontal sawing mill in scale. And I said, well, sounds pretty interesting. I think I can come up with some kind of a CAD drawing, and from there we can see where this is going to take us. And since this project is more about working than looking all that neat, I went a little bit more basic than on the doll, not as much detail, and I also got to slaughter one of my defective prized possessions, a big honking old calculating machine, funnily made by Astra, which I just couldn't get fixed and I didn't have the need for it. But it always had this big carriage with a nice roller-guided bed, and I saved those parts. And well, now here we are with a project which could need just that. So I'm going to go a little bit into detail about the construction, and after that we'll just dig right in through it. All in all, the basic idea is pretty simple. The carriage of the adding machine gets slaughtered and cut up into bits, which then make for the carrier of the saw blade. The entire carrier is mounted to a vertical slide via dovetails, which allow two threaded spindles to adjust the height of the blade, which then allows the operator to cut several boards from the tree trunk. The reciprocating motion of the saw blade is simply made by a crank drive and two bearing blocks right beside it. Alright, here is some of the parts that I was talking about. This is the carriage with the roller guides here, and I think this is a good place to start, because then we already have the, you know, thing that's doing the most motion, and we can attach other pieces to it and come up with a rather good-looking start right from the get-go. Hi, this is Cutting Adrian. I just wanted to let you know I was in a bit of a hurry getting this project finished before leaving for a month to Stuttgart. So I kept my explanations to a minimum, and right now while cutting I noticed that most things actually become self-evident after assembling them. So I figure you guys are smart, you're going to figure out what does what, and I'm going to keep my commentary to the minimum right now too, and focus on the machining. Enjoy, anyways. Well, don't ask me how I didn't see that coming. this point, I think it's probably smartest to just get rid of these both altogether and just put any kind of bar stock in here from behind and screw it into place. We'll make the dovetail pieces next. I had hoped to make two of these in one row, thus saving time. Unfortunately, I have nothing raw stock-wise which would permit that, so we're going to make two in parallel and then saw them off in the middle. I used a hole saw to cut the radii in the bearing blocks. That's because the trepanning tool didn't work so well. There we go. We'll do the vertical struts next. I only have this chunk of metal, so I'm going to part out two sections out of it to make them. This was a pretty bad idea. The steel I used seemed to be pretty tough, so I kept breaking tools. I tried mounting the tool behind the center line so it would spring out of the cut instead of into it. Didn't change anything much. Then I started drilling holes next to each other and tried chiseling out the bridge in between. I tried a slitting saw, which didn't cope with it. (laughs) Last not least, I just hacksawed through it and probably would have been much faster to just walk to the scrapyard, collect another piece of scrap and do it with that. Anyways, I powered through it. I rigged up a little something and filed and drilled and reamed two blocks here, which will act as the support for this top shaft to adjust the spindles up and down later on, and fix it all in place with just wire. And now we're going to use a torch and silver solder them in place just the way they are right now, hoping the heat won't distort everything and ruin what I've been trying to do. That didn't act right, if you ask me. Can you see how the solder is all at the top and none at the bottom? I think, if I remember correctly, the bottom piece was chrome plated, and probably now the chrome plating is what keeps the solder from sticking. Gonna put a wrench on it, see if it held up. And if it doesn't, we're going to have to clean it up and do it again. Well, I was wrong before, and I was right about that one. This one is nice and solid, so we're going to have to do this one again. See if I can relight the torch still. Well, that went very well, until it didn't. The problem is that the tool broke so far down in the holder that I can't grind a second tool out of it. So I guess it's back to doing it the old-fashioned way. I came, I sawed, I conquered. Well, that was tedious, no doubt about it, but I'll be honest, I don't think it was any slower than using the shaper. Of course, the shaper doesn't need to cool down and, you know, shake his muscles a little, but got it done in the end. Now, when you take a look down this piece, then you will probably notice that this is rather severely warped. And I am hoping that now that I weakened the structure, I'm going to be able to remedy that issue at least a little bit. Hammering on it got me so far, and for the last little bit I put the thing on the shaper and supported it with parallels, so number one I wouldn't mar the table, and number two I would have the one wonky side overlapping a little bit so that I could then tighten it down on the clamp and overstretch it in the other direction and bring it back straight. We've still got a tiny bit of wiggle in it, maybe half a millimeter or so. But if you take a look at it here, there is a remainder of a weld. So I'm just going to say that that's the remaining half millimeter. We need to remove some of the bottom anyways, and that side is only clearance, so it doesn't have to, you know, do anything special. It's just so it's remotely straight and won't start warping about while traveling back and forth. It doesn't need to do much more. This is 500 millimeters long. My shaper has a stroke of 275, so I can't machine this in one go, but I can drill a hole or cut a keyway in the middle as an interruption for the cut, and then machine both sides one after the other. So off camera I've made these little blocks and four more. They will be acting as guides for the table, you know, two in the middle, two behind and two up front. However, I've noticed that the guide actually, that the table actually has such an incredible weight on its own that it might be possible to just have it be guided on rollers. The future owner of this thing is experienced with model railroads, so he may have something in his stuff which could work on this. Now I admit this is going kinda rough, but also keep in mind that this is just a very rough mock-up here on some old boards of wood. The proper alignment and making a proper base for it is the job of the future owner. So, you know, this is more or less just to keep the parts together and to get a rough idea of how everything needs to be set up. The last thing I'll do in this video is make the two spindles for the up and down travel. I've taken regular threaded M4 rod and machined a step onto it, and then I machined these tubes essentially to go over it, and we will then silver solder them in place. The purpose of these is to take on the 5mm bore of the Kegelräder, and I will deliberately smear some solder onto the threads here and then machine it down to 4.5, which is the hole size that I drilled into the vertical support, so that I can then make sure we don't have steel-on-steel contact. Anyways, let's solder on. Welcome to the end of this video. It's off to the future owner of this thing for it now, and he's going to figure out the drive with an electric motor. He's going to figure out a way how to clamp the logs in the best way possible, and he's going to figure out if it's possible to just guide this table here using rollers instead of friction. And then we'll have to determine a proper feed rate for this thing. How much log can you haul through this at what RPM? And then I can go ahead and construct a feed mechanism for this, possibly even with a rapid feed to travel the carriage back to the beginning of the next cut. That's all for another video. I can't even tell you when that's going to happen. Might be half a year, might be a full year. We're going to see. As I said before, I will be visiting Stuttgart for a month now, so I don't have any time to, you know, deal with this sort of thing, nor do I have the tools. So yeah, this thing is best off being at the future owner, and he can do some tinkering with it. I hope you enjoyed the video. I know that I tried to push a lot of stuff into one video. I mean, look at all this. Still, I hope the cutting style didn't get too crumbobulated. If that was the case, my sincere apologies. I'll do better next time. Let me know in the comments. Bye bye! We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.